Shastra and Kavya on top. Shastra and Kavya. Kavya is imaginative literature and Shastra is intellectual literature, right? Then Shastra is divided into two sets, Apaurusheya, Paurusheya. I explained Paurusheya and Apaurusheya. Apaurusheya is not divine. Ki God came and taught logic to Kapil Kapoor. Nothing. Apaurusheya is, it is a knowledge which is non-contingent. It does not depend on an individual, on place, on time. It is true all time. It's true all time. For example, the force of gravitation, the law of gravitation, it used to apply since the creation, and it applies in England, it applies in India, and wherever you are. But it doesn't, because Newton or somebody has said it, that's why there is a law of gravitation. He formulated the law of gravitation, but he did not invent the law of gravitation. He didn't invent the law of gravity. He didn't invent gravity. Gravity was there, but he got it. That is reception. You see, that is how you receive knowledge. Nobody comes and tells you, you receive it. So that's a non-contingent, or the laws of motion, you know, that a thing at rest will continue to be at rest till external force is applied. This is true even of lazy human beings. They'll keep sitting unless you push him, get up. So it will be true all time. Now, Apaurusheya, under non-contingent knowledge, knowledge not dependent on individual person or place, you have the Vedas, four Vedas, and I've written something which you can read, and there are Vedangas, auxiliary sciences. I am saying non-contingent, you see, phonetics and all these shiksha that I read out, because they are scientific treatises, scientific. They are not falsified. If they say ta is produced like this, then wherever ta is produced in this world, it will have to be produced like this. And in all languages, in all languages. What we say universal, but that's not a good word. So it is scientific treatises, so it is non-contingent knowledge. Non-contingent. Paurusheya, it depends, because this is an individual's understanding of a domain of knowledge is involved. For example, logic. So Aristotelian logic is one. And there are, you know, three parts of a Aristotelian syllogism. Three parts. But the Nyaya, the Indian Nyaya, Indian logic is differently structured. Structured or systemed. Structured. And it has five stages. The syllogism in Indian thought has five steps. Five steps. In Eastern logic, it has three steps. So it is not Apaurusheya. It is not Apaurusheya. It is not non-contingent. It depends on the thinker who is organizing that knowledge.